What's up, guys? Welcome to today's video. I'm doing a commentary today on warm-up and how to properly warm up when it comes to a lot of the big movements, when it comes to weightlifting, how important it is, and how much people actually tend to neglect it. I actually made a post about this on my Instagram maybe a few weeks ago. I can't remember. About in middle of March, end of March. And I thought it actually be really helpful to put it on a YouTube video, and hopefully some people can see it and kind of actually I can dig a little deeper into each warm-up and what it all is about and how important it is when it comes to, you know, making sure that you're warming up properly, making sure that you are warming up the muscles, warming up the movement, and make sure you're in the right position to when you get to your heavier loads, you're in a safer position that way you don't get yourself hurt. And this is actually what I posted. This is what actually I wrote on my post about a few weeks ago. So this is exactly what I wrote. I'm going to read it to you guys. When it comes to the lifting weights and the big three movements, your squat, your bench, and deadlift, I believe it is important to warm up properly to the weight in which you are looking to hit for that day. Now, depending on what weight, depending on your one rep max or your certain percentage of weight you're playing, you will determine on how many or how to warm up leading up to your working weight. Whether you're building up to 104 pounds, 405, or 105 pounds, it's important to take the time and start being intentional about what we're doing when it comes to the gym. A warm-up allows us to properly practice technique form with lighter loads before you get set with a heavier weight. You have to treat your lightweights like heavyweights and your heavyweights like lightweights, is what I've always been told. It doesn't mean you have to do 10 sets or with tons of reps before you get to your working sets. I think that's all nonsense. I think you should do the proper amount of weight, proper amount of workload before you get to your working sets. With that being said, take your time and get in the game plan by doing 2 to 3 warm-up sets. Again, depending on what weight you're going up to, 8, 5, 3 rep range, maybe 1 or 2 rep range. Again, all depending on how many reps you're planning to do and hitting on your working weight. It's also important to conserve proper amount of energy for your main sets, and that means you're not too exhausted on your warm so that you can't hit all your proper reps or can't hit the proper amount of weight that you're trying to do for that day. Especially for people that are newer to lifting, you may be new to lifting, and it's a great way to practice and improve and reinforce certain things that you're working on. Again, before you get to your top sets, practice makes perfect. We'll make you perfect right away. But I'll tell you, the more you're intentional about doing something right, the better you'll become at it. And through this whole video, you kind of see my warm sets. So that's kind of what I posted about. There's a lot, little more information, but nothing that you guys need to worry about too much. So you can see all my warm sets there on my bench press. And you know, the biggest thing when I tell people to warm up, it's all depending on what you're working up to. And again, if you're not familiar with it, or you're not sure about how to warm up, then feel free to ask someone who is maybe more knowledgeable in that area, maybe a personal trainer, maybe someone locally that's been working out for a while, and get their advice on how to warm up properly and how to make sure you're doing the proper amount of sets, proper amount of reps before you get to a good working set that you want to perform for that day. So for most of my sets, I did maybe at 45, I maybe did 8 or 10 reps, I can't remember, 95 about 8 reps. Then I went to, I believe, 135 for 5, 175 for 5, and I did 205 for 3 sets of 5, I believe. Yes, that's my first working set. Let me go a little bit over technique and what I kind of look for when I bench press. First off, I take my shoes just because I feel like I'm a little more comfortable there. I can have more stable grip on the floor. I'm going to eventually transfer to maybe trying to lift a lot more often without my shoes and my socks so I can get a better grip on the floor. I think it's more beneficial. Then when I'm setting up against the bar, I'm trying to get my shoulder blades, my top of my shoulder blades on top of the bench, getting a pretty good arch in my low back, and get my glutes to be on the bench as well, pushing my knees out as I'm pressing up and trying to drive my feet in the floor as I'm pressing the weight up. So I'm really trying to push the whole bar away from my body when I do that. As I'm coming down, I'm actually loading the weight into my back. As you see, I'm trying to pull the bar into me using my back. And then when I'm pressing, I'm trying to really drive my head and neck back in the bar. Again, pushing my knees out, pushing my legs on the floor, and really trying to stay tight as much as possible. I believe a lot of things when you bench press, the bigger bench press you can get, the more you can work on your technique. And those are a couple of things that we really focus on, especially at the gym I work at. I think in general, when you lift weights and our bench press specifically, I think those are a couple things that you probably got to work on. Make sure you get a good arch in your low back, making sure that you can keep your glutes on the bench, upper back on the bench, so your shoulders don't go into it, and you can actually load the weight into your back and your chest and perform it to the best of your abilities. Take a big breath in your stomach, hold that pressure as you're lifting, and that will actually allow you to stay tight. As you can tell, my movement patterns, I'm pretty tight. I'm not moving too much with the weight, keeping myself pretty stable, and pressing through my heels as I press up, and then driving through my feet, I should say, and then trying to drive again. I'm trying to push myself away from the bar, keeping my elbows press up. So that's kind of the basics of the bench press. Throughout the rest of the workout, it's really more of a clip. Like this is a clip of me doing some skull crushers after my bench press workout that forced at the 10 there. And I just kind of want to go over the importance of warming up and why it's so important to do it. That's regards to all your main three lifts, your squat, your bench, and deadlift, and how it can actually save you from, prevent you from maybe having an injury in the long run when you do it. And again, like I said, you can practice proper technique, you can practice your movement pattern, you can practice certain things that you may need to work on to improve your weights and your performance in the gym when you get to your heavier loads. And that's it. So hopefully if you guys found this helpful, please give it a thumbs up. If you guys want a more detailed explanation, please comment below and let me know if you guys want more detail about maybe a squat or deadlift video and how to properly warm up for those and how to properly perform those at the highest level. So thanks for watching. Next couple clips are just me of squatting, deadlifting, and overhead pressing, and we'll talk to you soon. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I guess I'll continue on here. So this is my overhead press, actually. 95 for about 3 sets of 5. And then we'll have a couple videos of me squatting and deadlifting. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Subscribe if you haven't, and I'll catch you guys all in the next video.
Yeah.